by her entire house. She's empowered to do whatever she wants now. You'll be empowered to wear whatever clothes you want. You'll be empowered to know what to eat when you go out to the restaurant. You'll be empowered to go do any workout you want. You will be empowered to take on the world. That's what Life by Fitness is all about. Now, we have some technical stuff to go through, so everyone's going to need to grab their cell phones, but not just yet. We'll do that last. We have some ladies here that are going to share a story. But before they do, I want you to ask yourself these questions. What do you want to accomplish during this challenge and why? What is it you've decided you're going to go for? And if you don't have a goal, I assure you, you will not accomplish it. I repeat that. If you don't have a goal, you will not accomplish that goal. You must be very clear on what you want to accomplish. It's my experience. If you're clear on your goal, you clarify that, it happens. Sometimes quickly, sometimes slowly, but it happens. But more important than the what, the why. Why do you want to do it right now? Why is now the time? And some of you, I'm going to invite you to share. But I think it's important for you to know what and why I created Life by Fitness for. My what is I want to help empower people. I want people to feel like they can take on the world. I want people to feel like they are healthy and happy, confident, and strong enough to do anything. And so that's my what. My why is a little surprising probably. When I was a kid, I grew up in a pretty poor family. It was kind of sad. I was always like, oh my gosh, why is life so tough for me? And the other kids have all this cool stuff. And why is my mom and dad never home? And why, all these why's. But it was sports and fitness that made me feel good about myself. It was sports and fitness that gave me a really good sense of self-esteem and made it so I could make it through high school, make it through college, and really do well. It's because sports let me feel good about myself, but I didn't get that from my home. And when I did well in sports, people recognized me and I felt really proud and my self-esteem boosted up. I sort of felt loved. I felt important. And it felt good to have a healthy body. So the author of the story stopped then. And this is a part that I didn't tell a year ago. Because it's not really so flattering. But it's the truth and why I feel like that. When I hit 30 years old, I had it all figured out. I had a nice condo, a nice fiance, an awesome daughter, a great job, everything was fantastic. And I decided to do what my parents did, and I said I would never do. I went ahead and went down that little street called Drugs and Alcohol. And after I went down that street, I kept going. And I went far. And then I stopped. And then I would go again. And I went from having an awesome career, awesome family, awesome life, to people not knowing what to expect from me now. I went from doing really well to not doing so well. I went from trying my best to get back and then not get back. I went through so many ups and downs in a 10-year period. So if you've ever had ups and downs with your weight, if you've ever had ups and downs with your health and your program and your exercise, I can relate. I remember how hopeless I felt when I knew I needed to stop. It was so hard for me. I remember how I felt like, forget it, I had blown it. There's no sense even trying anymore. I got so far, I was living on a porch. I was homeless. Absolutely homeless on the porch of an abandoned house in the neighborhood that my mom lived in because I couldn't live with my mom anymore. This was not that long ago. 8 years ago. This is something I've been really embarrassed about my entire life. I was embarrassed about being poor when I was a kid. I was embarrassed about this. But what happened on that porch, and it's happened several times, is I had given up, and I had felt like there's no way I could get out of this rut. And there's this light. There's something inside all of us that connects us that said, all right, just come on, take another step. Take another step. And then something else clicked. Instead of worrying about, am I ever going to be good enough? Or am I ever going to do enough? Am I ever going to be successful enough? I started thinking, I've already blown it. I'm not going to be. Fine, I get it. But what can I do to help others? And ever since I turned my focus to helping others, it all sounds like a fairy tale, but everything's working. It's all in place. This all happened so fast. And I called it life light because that was the best way I could describe that feeling that I got inside me that made me feel like, you know what, don't give up. Because there's something still there. And nothing else could use that to help others. So that's my what, and that's my why. And if I can be that vulnerable with it and share it, I want you to be comfortable and share that as well. So before anybody wants to share theirs, and is there anyone that wants to share their what and their why, what they want to accomplish today, and during this challenge? Anybody have a strong what they're doing, why they want to do it? Well, I'm going to have to call my speakers up there for that. I knew they'd be here. All right, so we're going to start with Bella. Come on up, Bella. Give her a round of applause. Bella is a member. She did our last challenge.
The amazing people that I've met, my 5 a.m. crew right here, and I just love everything about life. It's not your typical gym. It's not a franchise. Tom's amazing. When I heard his story for the first time, I just fell in love with this place, and I knew I was going to become a member. I did the 28-day challenge. I lost 11 pounds. I lost a couple inches on my hips, almost 4 inches on my waist, went down 6% body fat, and myself and other people. It was, and I think we're all winners. It's not a matter because you're gonna win a prize. It's just we all work together, we support each other. Everybody's very, very positive. The Life Fitness page that we always make comments on, we've become friends. And I love getting up at 4 a.m, believe it or not, and coming here to Life Light. I do the 5 a.m. These girls got me running. I never used to run, I hated to run. And now I'm doing a mile. Thanks to these gals over here, Sarah and Lynette, and just, I really didn't like it. And I thought, but I'm gonna get the 2 miles eventually. And it's an amazing group. All the coaches are awesome. I don't have any complaints about anyone. They're very friendly. They teach you form, which is the most important. And that's all I can say. I just love this place.
Bella did a challenge and she decided to stick around and become part of the Life Light Fitness family, and we're so glad to have her. One more round of applause for Ron Bella. Thank you. Alright, so really quick at Life Light Fitness, you win. You win. And we've set this challenge up so everybody can win. There's not going to be one overall winner. Someone's going to win because of their arm measurement. Someone's going to win because of their check-ins. Someone's going to win because of their thigh reduction. Someone's going to win because of their pictures. Everybody wins. This is the challenge where everybody wins. And it starts with your workouts. Our workouts are all designed to get the most out of your 30 minutes. Nothing is by chance. Trainers do not make them up as you go along. They don't hope for the best. They know what to do. They know the timing. It's all scientifically based. I have a physiology degree from Davis, and I've been doing this for about 20 years. I've learned what works, and I use science to develop all of our workouts. So the trainer's gonna add their own twist to it, but with all the same scientific format. So the W stands for workout, the most effective 30-minute workouts in the universe. All right, this woman got second place in our last challenge. She actually lost so much body fat and weight. I'm gonna let her share her story right now. And she has a huge smile.
Thank you, Coach Tom. It's a big thank you. You know, when I had my physical and my doctor said that, you know, I'll put you on tablets, weight loss tablets, because, you know, I was overweight and all my numbers were not correct. I told her, give me 2 months. And I joined Life Light Fitness, and I lost 10% of my body fat in like 4 weeks. And a big thank you to Coach Tom. I will say this is a very good motivational place, and it always helps you, encourages you. Coaches are good, my client crew is good. They will be like, you can do it, you can do it. It's always like, you know, you cannot just stand for a second in that class. And I would like to tell you that, you know, just don't give up on anything. It's like, it's a step-by-step process. It's a process, it's a small steps which you take every day, which will help you to get your end results for this. And, you know, just come, be regular, follow the diet, follow what instructions your coaches give you in Coach Tom. I would say I'm following the diet, you know, I'm an Indian, and like there were friends, there were people telling me, oh, you're an Indian, like, you know, how can you not eat the rice and roti and dal and sabzi? I was like, you know, if I want to do that, I will, like, you know, I will give up on my that part. It's there are times when I feel like, you know, no, I need to go back to my roots. That time I put the curry on my salad and I eat it. That's how I decided to start my taste. So just like, you know, just follow what Coach Tom tells you and the coaches tell you. They are awesome. Thank you.
I had a quick little wardrobe change. All right, the N stands for nutrition. All of our programs come with nutrition. We are gonna start everybody off with a 4-week meal plan. If you haven't seen it, I've attached it to a whole member resource site. It's gonna have your success manual, your goal sheet, your dining out guide. We're adding a measurement video to it. We're always updating that site, so it's more than just a meal plan. It's just a resource for you when you have questions. And speaking of resources, you also have our Facebook page where you'll have trainers answering your direct questions every day. So nutrition, you'll start off with a 4-week plan. Most people do it twice. We have a 6-week plan. We have a paleo plan. We have vegetarian plans. We are huge on nutrition. It's very, very important. All right, so the next letter I'll tell you about. But first, I'm going to bring up Lynette, who also got great results and actually is now our Healthy Success Coordinator, working with sponsors and stuff, so she's really involved. Round of applause for Lynette.
Well, first off, I just want to tell you, I really give you guys a lot of credit to come, because that's a really hard decision. I've known Tom for quite a few years. In 2010, I broke my back, and I was told that I would never be able to run again. I was told that I would never be able to wear high heels again. I was told I would never be able to ride a bike again. They told me I had to get one of those bikes that you go like this on. And I'm like, I am not gonna be a grandma, thank you very much. They also told me that I would never weightlift again at all. So when I met Tom, he partnered with me with Tevin. And I don't know if Tom remembers the first time Tevin asked me to do squats or to do something with some heavy bars. I looked at him like he was psycho. And it has been the most amazing experience because now I do heavy lift. Now I run a mile in the morning before and after my workout. Now I'm not an emotional eater, and I have 2 children on the autism spectrum. So there's so much you can conquer in this, ladies. This group will really show you who you are as a woman, and you're gonna roar, and I'm really excited to watch you.
I'm just really grateful for the ladies who come up and speak because I believe their experience matters way more than what anything I can say. Because I want you to visualize yourself up here. Visualize your body changing, your confidence changing, the way you walk, carry yourself, and the whole just list of benefits that come, not just from losing some weight. That's not what we're here for. We're here for making lifestyle changes that you continue for the rest of your life. And that's what we're about. We want to empower you to live your life differently. That way you have different results and you have a different feel. And it's basically an overall stronger empowerment. So the I, you are inspiring someone right now, just being here. someone is like, you told them you're going to come tonight, you told them you're going to start this challenge, and they're inspired. Some of you, you've been doing this for a while, and you're really inspiring someone. Could be your kids. Some people will say it to you, some people won't, some people will write about it, some people won't, but they're telling someone else. If you have kids, they might not tell you, but they're telling their friends, hey, my mom's getting buff.
On Instagram.
Yeah. It happens. You're inspiring someone else that's scared to take the first step. Something happened with all of you in this room where you said, okay, I'm going to go try this place. I'm going to do this challenge. I'm going to go for it. Something happened. You're inspiring people because of it. So I honor you for that. I'm very, very glad. And that's why I love getting up in the morning and coming to work, because I'm inspired by people that are brave enough to take that first step. I know what it's like to be brave enough to do that thing that's so hard to do. And you're doing it. Speaking of inspiring, one of my favorites also, Sarah, come on up. I love your smile. I love your attitude.
Thank you very much. I feel like Bob Barker with this tiny microphone. So where do I even begin? I started at LifeLight with a Hot Mommy Challenge back in March, and a bunch of my girlfriends had done it the previous September. And it just wasn't in the cards for me at that time. I was working in the city, and I couldn't fathom how I could work working out into my day with an hour and a half each direction commute. So I kind of let that one go, and when it came back again in March, I had switched jobs and was working in Pleasanton, and I thought, well, this is like the perfect opportunity. Now I'm right here in town. There's literally no excuse why I can't do this. And I had been wanting to do it for a really long time. I was overweight most of my life. When I was six, I encountered a very traumatic event, and I started emotional eating after that. And I just packed on the weight, and I was that chubby kid forever. Just after college, I lost a little bit of weight, got some confidence, and things got better, and then I had kids. And you know what happens with that. I'm still working on losing my baby weight. My baby's almost 11. Anyway, when I joined here, I was really out of shape. I wasn't working out at all. I had gone back and forth between trying to eat healthy and clean, and then just, you know, going off the deep end. And when I first walked in this door, all of my girlfriends were working out at what I called at-home mom time, about 10 a.m. When, you know, working people are at work. Or they'd go in the evening. And I just couldn't commit to any of those times a day. And I am not a morning person at all. Prior to coming to LifeLight, it would take me like 3 hours before I could even deal with people. And that's with coffee. So me waking myself up to come here to work out at 6 a.m. was already an incredible feat. And now I've worked my way down to 5 a.m. Love my 5 a.m. crew. And I just love it. I get up at 4:25 every morning with a smile on my face. I jump out of bed most days. I'm not going to lie. Some days it's really hard. I jump out of bed, throw on my gym clothes, and I get here, and like by the time I'm here, my brain catches up, and it's like, what? We're working out? What's going on? And then I'm doing it. Lynette has inspired me to start running. I also hated running forever. I'm tall, and I have bad knees, and running is not really for big people with bad knees. And I said, screw it, and I did it anyway. And I'm so glad I did, because I actually love running now. I can't believe I'm saying those words, but I do. We even sprint on occasion, and it's totally worked out well, because I play softball on Thursday nights, and I run faster now. We actually just won the championship, so I like to say I had a little to do with that. Anyway, going back to what I'm actually here to do, a little advice. When you think you can't do it, you're probably right. But if you tell yourself that you can do it, you will blow yourself away with what you're able to accomplish. I legit have run up this wall and did a pull-up. Literally ran straight at the wall, hoisted myself up and did a pull-up. It still blows my mind. You will find, if you allow yourself to try, that you will be able to do a lot of things you didn't know that you could do, and it feels so good when you do that. Also, nutrition is so important. Yes, you can have a cheat meal every week. And, you know, sometimes you get a little lured in by wine or whatever. But I'm telling you right now, nutrition is like number one. You cannot like outwork out your terrible eating. It just won't work. You're not gonna get the results you want. If you want real results, you have to stick to the meal plan or some variation of it that is still healthy. But have your cheats, because you'll go crazy if you don't. An interesting thing I found is that since I started eating a lot healthier, I can notice when I eat something bad, I notice immediately the effects. For example, I had ice cream two nights ago, and it sounded like a great idea at the time. My son and I really enjoyed it, and then I was up all through the night, because eating terrible stuff affects my sleep, and I cannot deal with not having sleep, especially when I get up at 4 something in the morning. Another thing that I've done that has helped me be really successful is not allow myself to make one single solitary excuse ever, no matter what. I have worked out here at 5 or 6 a.m. every single day, 6 days a week since March. There was literally one day that it didn't happen. It was on a Saturday. I stayed up too late doing bad things, and I left my phone at my friend's house, and then I had no way to wake up. So, my bad, that was only the one time I missed. But literally, I come here, I've been here hungover, I've been here on 3 hours of sleep. I just don't let myself ever have an excuse. And then, guess what? You just work out every day, and then you feel really good. And by the way, working out is probably the best hangover cure ever. Even better than menudo and tacos. Seriously, I'm serious. You'll sweat it out instantly. Other advice, I can't speak enough about how welcoming this place is. When I walked in here, I didn't really know anybody in my classes because all my friends went at other times, and I felt super awkward at first. But right when I walked in, people were friendly, they were smiling at me, they welcomed me right in, and I felt like part of something, which is awesome. And the trainers are the same way. They're gonna push you, they're gonna make you do more reps, you're gonna think you have to drop down, but they're gonna keep telling you to get back up, and you do it because you want to. And they encourage you in a way that's not scary or mean. They push you because you need to be pushed. We all do, or we wouldn't be here. And then same thing with the friends that you meet. Like, it's incredible the group that we have now that we're so bonded, we're so tight. And we have inside jokes. We get ridiculous in the morning because 5 a.m. is the perfect time to do such a thing. We dance. We have a great time. So I just encourage you all to remind yourself why you're here and tell yourself, even if you have to look at yourself in the mirror every day and say, you're freaking awesome. You're going to do this. You can totally do this. Seriously, like, you're good enough. You're smart enough to talk to other people like you. It's true. Tell yourself, because if you don't believe it, no one else will. Why would they? So tell yourself you got this, you deserve it, you can do it, and then your mind will catch up, everything will catch up.
Well, that's
great. That's pretty much all I got.
And thank you very much, Broadway, and shared their experience today. So mindset is a huge important thing, and it's hard to put like a label or variable on it, but I'm that guy. For so long I had to say, okay, you can do this. You didn't mess it all up so bad, this is really happening, just do the next right thing. And I had to battle self-talk, where my self-talk was saying, no, you would, there's no way, might as well give up now. Oh, there's no way no one's gonna take you serious. Oh, stop. They know that you used to be a drug addict and alcoholic. They knew that you blew everything, you lied to people. They're not gonna trust you. And that was self-talk for too long. And I was in hiding for too long. Like when Sarah said something happened and she used food to go to hiding, I was literally in hiding because I was so worried about people's opinion. So that self-talk's gonna come up. It's called doubt, it's called worry, it's called fear, and deal with it. Laugh at it. I call it the R3. Recognize it. Release it, replace it. I had to do that. That's how I survived. I recognized it, well, there it is again. I released it and I replaced it. I got this. And sometimes that same thing. I'm good enough. Yeah, I sound like Tony Robbins' guru or dork or something, but I had to do it because I needed to replace it. Don't let negative thinking stay. Recognize it, release it, replace it. Now I'm to the point, oh, there it is again, that self-doubt, and I laugh at it. And then I release it, and I replace it with, I'm gonna help someone today. It doesn't work if you think things like, I'm gonna be rich, I'm gonna get rich, I'm gonna do this, I'm gonna be strong. That doesn't work. I tried it. It doesn't work. If you say, I'm gonna do something to be of service today, I'm gonna help someone today, amazing things happen. And by you doing your best here, you're gonna help someone. So there's some housekeeping things we want to cover before you go, because I wanna make sure everybody knows what's going on and they can do all their check-ins. Before we grab our phones, I wanna make sure, raise your hand if you've already downloaded Zen Planner. Zen Planner. Okay, good. You wanna make sure we do that. Raise your hand if you've already done your first Facebook check-in. When you check in, not only does it help you win prizes and qualifies you, it helps people see what you're doing and inspires them. Plus, we pay to be part of a brand called Causely. Every time you check in, we donate money. We donate money to a different cause every month. We're all about being of service and giving back, so your check-ins help a lot. So when you check in, you're going to check in with, on your own personal page, and tag Tom Miller and tag Lifeline. If you have not added yourself to the Bikini Body Challenge Super Summer Shape Up page, do so. All of your resources are right there. Okay, before I take questions, really quick. Food is an F word. She is right. Nutrition is huge. We get great results because we focus on nutrition and mindset also. Food is an F word. Some of you have heard this before, so bear with me. Most of it, we eat for flavor. We eat for fun. When I said food is an F word, how many of you thought I was going to say bad F word? No? I wasn't going to say. All right. Often we eat for feelings. Those are the F words we've been using. Sometimes it's because of our friends, our family. Oh, come on, eat this. Starting today, I need you to be accountable. I need you to be very aware of what F word you're eating. What F word are you eating? And this is the one I want you to shoot for the next 4 weeks. I want you to eat for fuel. Food was made to fuel our bodies. What Lynette talked about, or what Sarah talked about, when she ate the ice cream, she didn't feel great. That wasn't fuel, that was flavor. You're right. Have it. But as long as you're aware of it, that's all. I will never say the word go on a diet to you. I will never say go on a diet. I do not believe in them. They don't work. I will never give you guilt about something you eat. Some of you, Coach Tom, last night I ate a bunch of French fries with some ice cream and some sugar. And I say, okay. That's it. It's not guilt. Guilt doesn't help. I've tried guilt too. It won't work. Just makes you want to do it again later. What does help is being aware. So awareness is your first task. What F word are you eating? Okay, before we go and we get phones and stuff and answer all questions, does anyone else have a major question? How many of you have not ever been a member with us before? We have a mix of members and non-members. If you're not a member, raise your hand. If you're not a member. So one of the things that happen are people say, what happens when the challenge is over? What happens? So Ray, keep your hand up, they're gonna give me an envelope. Now, I don't do sales, I don't like them. I've worked for gyms that do lots of sales and tricky stuff. Mm-hmm. I just do value. So there's a opportunity for you in the envelope that you can sign up for today. It's only available to you today, but I want you to do it because you see value in it, and I made it easy. You're going to get your first month for half off, and you're gonna be able to become a member without paying a $100 enrollment fee. And you're not gonna pay anything today. You're not gonna pay a single cent.